hair smells like beer.
Oh.
We always do this. We always film a 2K Mats video right when I come home from work and my hair is droopy and smells like alcohol.
Whose fault is that? I don't know who you want to blame. You can only blame yourself. I never smell like beer. I don't know what to tell you.
Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of 2K Mads. It's Matt Steele.
And it's Matt Palmer.
And according to Matt Palmer, it is a state of emergency. He texted me while I was at work at my restaurant, and he was just like, you need to come home as soon as you can because we're filming a 2K Mads, a fourth one in 1 week.
I know.
Which is a record for us. We're making up for all the weeks where we've skipped.
Exactly.
And he was just like, I'm not going to tell you what we're reacting to. And I was like, okay. I was worried that it was something bad. I was horrified that like the Spice Girls were going to get two new girls or something.
That was the immediate thought.
I like stayed off Twitter because the answer would be on Twitter.
Yes.
On Facebook, the only thing that people were sharing were the new Spider-Man trailer. I'm assuming it's not the new Spider-Man trailer.
Good thinking. It is not the new Spider-Man
trailer. That's not something that I would be excited for. What's happening that I needed to rush home
for? This sucks. I love having a secret. I kind of don't want to tell you.
I'm like really scared. It's a good thing.
Yes.
Okay.
It's a song.
Okay.
Okay, a song was released.
Officially released. Jeez.
I know, but it was I guess they're pulling a Beyonce.
Oh my god.
Surprising everyone. It's from the 50 Shades Darker soundtrack.
Wait, we're having another 50 Shades movie?
There's another 50 Shades movie.
Okay, new
special. And there's a new soundtrack.
There's a new soundtrack.
There's a new single.
A new single.
A new single is performed by...
Bye!
A young man named Zane.
Okay.
And he's performing the song with...
Oh!
His former bandmate's ex-girlfriend. Sit down! The reaction's the whole point!
What happened? How did this happen?
Taylor Swift.
Wait. Weren't you saying, like, after Taylor Swift got a little bit by Kanye and Kim, weren't you, like, saying Taylor needs to be out of the spotlight for a solid year? I was expecting a 2017 without Taylor, a Taylor-less year, which, like, she's putting out a song.
It's a song from a soundtrack. It's not the first single from her album.
Okay.
She just tweeted like T.S. Zane and then like a link to the song. Not even a link, just like the cover art. And it's just like, bitch.
Savage. We were like, she needs to be out of the spotlight so people like won't get tired of her, blah, blah, blah.
And again,
but she's just like, nope.
Yeah. And much like Beyonce in 2013, it's Christmas. There was no more music to be released this year, and most certainly not by a Taylor Swift.
Like,
I am wondering, because okay, it's all just come out that Taylor is working with Drake on her new album or like some new music, so like,
okay, and the fact I didn't
that she's
know this.
Doing like a song for the 50 Shades Darker soundtrack with Zane, like, is this going to be like an R&B Taylor Swift hip-hop influenced song? Like, what are we about to hear?
This is so smart, because it's like got the British fans for Zane, the American fans for Taylor coming together. This could be bigger and last longer on Billboard than Once
Week. Don't say that! We haven't even heard the song yet.
It could most certainly be garbage.
So I guess now
I'm so scared.
The song is called, I think, I Don't Want to Live Forever. Today we're trying something new since we can no longer post reactions to our YouTube channel. Make sure to go over to our Facebook to see our full reaction to the song as it's playing, because YouTube is going to take us down.
It's going to
murder us in our sleep if we do that here. So.
None of you want that.
You don't want that.
So go to our Facebook to see.
Love.
You homo. That was sexy.
Wow.
God, okay.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, I think Taylor worked.
I think she
definitely
worked.
Like, it wasn't too R&B to be. This is ridiculous for Taylor Swift to be a part of.
I'm wondering how this song came to be. Like, okay. When I look now at the cover, Zane is listed first, so I'm thinking this must have been a Zane song that Taylor was brought on to and to, to add. Like, I think she wrote that bridge, and I think she probably wrote the lyrics to her verse, but I think it was just like a full song that she was thrown onto. But it's not a bad fit. I think the production being really sparse is cool.
Love a sparse production.
I love, you know, those little plunks.
Like the plunks, it's like a wooden Asian instrument, and like dripped raindrops on it.
Yes, exactly. Reminds me of those rain sticks from childhood. You remember
that? Yes,
oh, yes. I love those. We should get one. I love the like,
obviously.
I think it's very, Take On Me, aha. It's also very Bastille. It just has like that 80s moment. It's like, remember 1989? You liked that, didn't you? I think the pre-chorus is really great. The only part I'm not loving is that first chorus. Like the first part of the chorus.
I wanna live.
Yeah, I don't. I mean, I think it's just the falsetto's very high, and like, I don't know if Zane is like.
Oh, I like it.
I don't think it's like catchy catchy enough, and I also don't think, like, he sounds wonderful in that register, so.
Oh, I actually think he sounds really good.
Oh, I don't think so.
I actually, like, I really like it.
It's the one part I would change. If I could change anything, if I could just mold it and make it a little perfect.
I feel like the only part I would change, I wish I could listen to the bridge again, because I didn't really get the biggest feel for the, but that's because it's a bridge. It doesn't repeat, you know?
Yes.
Good job dropping this bombshell on the world, guys.
It definitely took us all by surprise. I feel like this is definitely a transitional sound for Taylor, and I think we're going somewhere.
Oh God.
This next album.
What are we doing?
I don't know where we're going, but so far I'm on board, but I'm definitely like, keeping my ear to the ground. As much as like 1989 was like a big pop album, I could see this being even further in like a direction. I don't know. I don't know what direction, but I feel like we're going somewhere.
Not just one direction.
Oh God.
In multiple directions.
Boom, oh boom, my boom. God. Do you think they told Harry before it came out?
I don't know.
Zane was like, FYI.
Well, we gotta get a statement from Harry. That's what we're really here
for. Harry, if you'd like to join us on the 2-Gay Mats, we are available.
There's
for
an open spot
right
here.
You'll be right
you
in the middle.
You can join us if someone knows how to get in here.
Yes, we'll make sure that you get the best lighting. You're gonna love it.
Man. Huh. Okay.
That really came out of left field. I wonder if you're as shell-shocked as we are. Tell us in the comments below, what's your favorite part of the song? What do you think the performances are gonna be like? Do you think, like, there's gonna be a music video with them together? Are they gonna, like, be love interest in said music video? Like, how's the song gonna work?
That would be great.
Well, tell us below what you see for the future of this song. Follow us on Twitter at Matt Palmer Music.
And it's Matt Steele.
Yes, like the video, share with all your friends. Follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/2gaymats. And I guess we'll see you probably tomorrow
with another episode. Lord knows, at the rate we're going.
Exactly, with another episode of 2gaymats. Bye, y'all.
Bye, y'all. Love ya.
Don't want to live forever.
I do.